hundreds of trillions of dollars?
Really?
In the US? Let's define a little bit what that means. We all know about the US federal debt, but let's not forget Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid. Then we've got personal, individual debt, which of course we all know about credit cards, mortgages, even student loans. But let's not forget about, we've got state government debt in bonds, we've got local government debt in bonds, and we've got other public authorities like DIA. Add in now the private sector, of which then they have their own loans and bonds, as well as, of course, the giant piece of commercial real estate. Then you see the hidden part of all of the pledges, the bailouts, and the worst of the worst, the toxic assets. So my point is, if we're going to be leaders, as Kim has challenged us, what can we do? Well, I've got seven areas that I want to address that. The first is the assessment of risk. There are formal organizations that look at the probability of the debtor to repay the obligation. And this, of course, then means assessing interest rates, terms, and, of course, the ultimate of what do I pledge as an asset or a security. These kinds of things have various ratings, various ups and downs, but an example I'll give is working with a small business who goes to a bank, and the bank in the last 4 years is now saying, I want 300% coverage in assets. So what that means is, of course, very low risk for the bank, but they are basically taking or have a call on the assets of the business and then assets of all of the owners. And so that means their homes, their boats, and anything else that they may have. The second area that I want to address in terms of a technique is debtor's prison. Now, you all know what that means because it's been around for thousands of years, and indeed it was the main recourse up until even the 1800s. In fact, Australia was the debtor's prison for all of the British Empire. Now, what you may not know is that there are certain debts that you're just not going to get out of, and they are indeed debtor's prison. An example is if you don't pay child support, you're going to prison. There are other examples along the lines of IRS and student loans. But you basically have to understand the concept of debtor's prison is still with us. The next is the idea, the third topic, the moral obligation to repay debt. In this context, we've got individuals, businesses, even countries that have a moral obligation as well as a legal obligation. Well, within that context, you have bankruptcy laws that can get rid of most of the legal obligation, but as I just talked about debtor's prison and other kinds of things, you can't get rid of them all. So the net of what happens with moral obligation is that if you default any terms, then you basically have two things happen. You drop a few notches in the court of public opinion, as well as, guess what, back to the ratings that I mentioned of risk, you also then end up with gigantic risk, or otherwise known as low credit scores. And of course, that applies to individuals, businesses, and even countries, as we now know. The fourth area to talk about is usury. Basically, this is the idea of there's laws that limit the amount of interest that should be paid. As an example, in Colorado, the criminal limit is 45% annual percentage rate. And I'm thinking, you know, I would loan people at 44% because that's going to cover a lot of risk. And so when you look at what is all about usury, it basically goes back to that first point of when you do the risk assessment, you've got lots of different levers that you can pull to make that work. The eighth concept to understand how to manage debt is below market interest rates. What this really says is after you get the risk assessment of interest, terms, and what you're going to get for the security, but you purposely then assess or charge less. What that means then is you're giving somebody a gift, or it's called compensation. In essence, the IRS steps in and adjudicates what's going on. The good part about this is it's now being used in philanthropy. So you can get a nonprofit business, and if they're generating revenue, they can actually now get bonds. Or another way is that the IRS approves community development banks to which you've heard, of course, of microloans. So there's a lot of good use that still accumulates this big number of hundreds of trillions totally. The sixth area is converting debt to equity. The best example I would ask you to do is Google General Motors bankruptcy. You may be shocked to find out at one point the U.S. government owned the equity of General Motors at more than 60%. The concept here of when you start to step in and take over the equity, like calling a loan or taking somebody's home, the idea is basically you now own the asset and you can either sell it, or if it generates a lot of cash, you keep it and pay yourself. The context here that I use that's a positive is think of, again, a small business needs a couple of million dollars. The bank says, no way. So you go to an investor. And you basically ask the investor to write a loan, pay them 12% interest, but you give them the benefit of converting to equity at any point during the loan. So everybody wins in that kind of a context. The last of the seven is this idea of securitization. And that's the idea of assets that produce enough cash to pay the principal and the interest and profit, package them together, get a rating, and even some insurance. Now, does that vaguely sound familiar? That was what Lehman Brothers did with the below prime rate kinds of mortgages. Then they went to Standard & Poor's, got the rating, and then AIG did the insurance. So the bottom line, when you start to look at these seven different approaches, they do a pretty good job of covering the hundreds of trillions of obligations, but the truth is they can only be met in the United States if there's significant economic growth. And by that I mean increases of revenue, very huge for an individual or a business or the country. And the worst, have to have significant inflation. Package those together and the hundreds of trillions may actually be paid.